Hi, my name is Dr. Mark D'Agostino, and I'm on the admissions team at Top Test Prep. Today, we're going to talk about what is a good MCAT score. The MCAT, or the Medical College Admission Test, is the most feared and misunderstood aspect of the medical school admissions process. We're going to discuss three steps to help to demystify the test. We want to, one, understand what it assesses, two, how it's scored, and then three, we'll talk about the, quote, three B's, unquote. The Medical College Admission Test, or MCAT, is a computerized exam which is offered up to 25 times per year at ProMetric test centers. There are four main sections that are tested on the MCAT in the following order. There's the physical sciences section, which is 52 questions over 70 minutes. The verbal reasoning section, 40 questions over 60 minutes. Then there's a writing sample, which consists of two essays in which you're allocated 60 minutes to complete those. And you conclude the test with the biological sciences section, which is 52 questions over 70 minutes. Now we'll talk about how the MCAT is scored. The physical sciences, the verbal reasoning, and the biological sciences sections are each scored numerically between 1 and 15. The writing sample is scored from J through T. Therefore, the highest score possible is a 45T, which would be a 15 in each of the sections, physical sciences, verbal reasoning, and biological sciences, as well as the maximum score on the writing sample. Now, we're going to discuss some of the data. In 2008, according to the AAMC, there were over 75,000 test takers. The mean composite score, meaning when you add the score of the physical sciences, verbal reasoning, and biological sciences together, was a 24.9, with a standard deviation of about 6.4, which means that the average person scored approximately an 8 in each section, and the standard deviation was between a 6 and a 10 in each section. The writing sample score, the average was an O on the J to T scale. The data for the matriculating students is a little bit different. In 2008, the average composite MCAT score of those admitted to any allopathic, which means schools that grant the MD degree, medical schools in the United States, was approximately a 30, with a writing sample score of a P. And the average for many medical schools is significantly higher than this. The three B's are balance, better than the mean, and the best score possible. First, we will discuss balance. A balanced score is arguably the most important component of a good MCAT score. For example, a perfectly balanced 36T, which would be a 12 in all of the sections, plus a T on the writing sample, is unequivocally a great score. However, a balanced 29R with a physical sciences score of 9, verbal reasoning of 10, biological sciences of 10, with a solid writing sample score may be preferable to a widely varied 33J, for example. When we say better than the mean, a good MCAT score generally needs to be approximately one standard deviation, which is about 6 points, as we discussed previously, above the mean. This translates to roughly a 10 in each section and a P or Q in the writing sample. Now, when I say the best score possible, it sounds obvious, but to assess this last factor, you really need to be honest with yourself. Could you teach the MCAT material to someone else? If not, then you may not be ready to take the exam. Many people underestimate what it takes to succeed on the MCAT the first time. Investing the time and investing in yourself is vital. If you fall short, you can recalibrate, you can develop a more detailed plan, and with our help, you can make it happen. Top Test Prep can help you improve your MCAT score. Call us at 800-501-PREP or visit us online at toptestprep.com.